Be Wealthy and Smart, episode 868.
Into a world of wealth and financial freedom without budgets, boredom, or bosses on Be Wealthy and Smart. And now, here's your host, Linda P. Jones.
Welcome to Be Wealthy and Smart. I'm Linda P. Jones, America's Wealth Mentor, empowering women and men worldwide to financial freedom. On today's show, we're going to talk about mortgage rates are tumbling because I promised I would report back to you with what interest rates were doing, and I did say I thought they would be coming down and you would have another opportunity to do some refinancing. And that's just what we're seeing right now. This article comes to us from Yahoo Finance, and it says, "Tumbling mortgage rates put Americans in more of a borrowing mood." And it was written by Nancy Sarnoff. And it says, with mortgage rates down at their lowest levels in more than a month, people in the industry are seeing evidence that homeowners and home buyers are latching onto cheaper loans. A lenders trade group says a long slump in mortgage applications, especially for refinancing loans, showed signs of improvement once rates started coming down. Meanwhile, buyers in many parts of the country are diving full force into the housing market. Rates are still incredibly low in people's minds, said Corey Burr, a real estate agent with TTR Sotheby's International Realty in Washington, D.C. Demand for mortgages has been fluctuating, but may be showing early signs of a turnaround. Though mortgage applications declined during the first full week of April, most of the pullback came earlier in the week when rates were higher, says Joel Kahn, chief forecaster for the Mortgage Bankers Association. The MBA says the average rate for the 30-year fixed-rate mortgage fell to 3.27%, the lowest since mid-March. More recent data from mortgage giant Freddie Mac shows 30-year rates have taken a dive to an average 3.04%, a six-week low. The MBA's most current numbers are from the week ending April 9th, when overall mortgage applications fell 3.7%, driven by lower refinance applications. Refi requests fell 5% for the week and were 31% lower than during the same week last year. But applications for loans to purchase houses slipped by just 1% and were up 51% from the same week a year ago when the pandemic shut down open houses and mortgage offices. Buyers feel like they're getting very close to free money. Our market is still white hot, says Burr. Mortgage rates remain low by historical standards, and that's played a big role in keeping real estate agents and mortgage brokers busy. Rising COVID-19 cases and a vaccine setback conspired to push rates down following weeks of steady increases, says Matthew Speakman, an economist with Zillow. But don't assume the lower mortgage rates are going to stick around. The outlook for rates is still likely upward, barring any additional setbacks for the nation's recovery from the pandemic, Speakman says. If you've been thinking about refinancing your mortgage to cut your interest rate and monthly payment, this could be a good time to make a move. Black Knight, a mortgage data and technology provider, on Monday released a new estimate that 13 million homeowners could still save an average of $283 a month by refinancing their loans. If you go the refi route, don't settle for the first mortgage rate offered to you. Be sure to check rates from multiple lenders to find the best deal in your area. Another way to save on your housing expenses is by shopping around for homeowners insurance. When you buy or renew a policy, compare rate quotes from several insurers to find the lowest price on the coverage you need. End of article. Well, I think a lot of people are still trying to find a home. Again, there's not a lot of inventory right now, and we're seeing multiple offers and bidding wars happening. So you don't want to overpay for a home. And I think a year from now, we're probably going to see a completely different situation with many, many more homes available. So don't get discouraged if you're shopping for a home. Do some things to prepare for your home over the next year. Prepare for getting a down payment ready. Prepare for getting your credit the best that it can be. Improving your credit score, prepared to know what neighborhood you're looking at, and if you need to know what the school situation is in the neighborhood. Do your research during this time so that when you're ready to buy, and maybe if it's 6 months or a year from now, more inventory might be available in homes and you might just luck out and be able to get a low rate mortgage with a good price on a home. Let's hope so. If you haven't yet subscribed to Be Wealthy and Smart, hit the subscribe button and you'll be notified as soon as new podcasts are available so you never miss one of them. And if you are looking to improve your credit score, I've got some great podcasts on that on my podcast page at lyndapjones.com/podcasts, where all of my podcasts are listed from the very beginning, which is many more than what Apple has on Apple Podcasts. So you can go to my website, go to the podcast page, and then in the search box, put the keywords that you're searching for and pull up whatever topics you want to know more about. And you'll find them in my podcast, Wealth Mentoring Library, on my website. That's all for today. Until next time, live the good life and be wealthy and smart.
Thank you for listening to Be Wealthy and Smart with Linda P. Jones. Share the wealth and tell your family and friends about the show. Check out our website, blog, and social media for more riches at www.bewealthyandsmart.com.